And good morning, fellow ticket holders, from this beautiful view from our room here at the Hojo in Anaheim. You can see outside of our window here, we have this gorgeous view this morning of the mountains as the sun's starting to rise. And we are very excited for today because today will be a full day of the Disneyland park. Yesterday we did get to go into the park for a little bit in the afternoon. Actually we got a lot done. We got to see the parade, we got to ride about 5 rides. I actually forgot that we had Genie Plus as part of our ticket, so we thought we were just gonna wander around and do what we could, and I'm like, wait, we bought Genie Plus. So we got to do a few rides, especially Indiana Jones. I got to pick that up, so that was great to do it after its refurbishment. But enough of what we did yesterday, let's move on for today. I'm gonna be doing a full day at the park. I'm gonna be meeting up with a friend that I haven't seen in a while, so it'll be great to hang out with him. It'll be his first time here at Disneyland, so it'll be so much fun to show him this park. He has been to Disney World before, so to get his reaction on how he thinks Disneyland is different from Disney World will be fun. Let's just get going with the day. Let's go have a great day at Disneyland. So getting from the Howard Johnson's to Disneyland is super simple. Just started here and work your way down Manchester Street to the corner of Harbor. Then you make your way down Harbor Boulevard to the corner of East Shuttle Area. And we are here. Let's make our way through security and get in line to get into the park. And we have made it through security, and look at these cool Disney 100 banners. These are really neat. So let's head on over into Disneyland.
In 1955, Walt Disney spoke those immortal words inviting guests to step inside the happiest place on Earth for the very first time. As we celebrate 100 years of the Walt Disney Company, we are grateful for the many friends and families who have shared this wondrous journey with us from generation to generation. And we hope you are as excited as we are to see what the next century will bring. For your safety, please walk to your next destination. Thank you, and welcome to Disneyland.
Yay, through the castle we go towards Batuu. All right, we have made it to a galaxy far, far away into Batuu. We're gonna work our way towards Ronto Roasters for breakfast and get a Ronto wrap. So for breakfast here at Ronto Roasters, we did pick up 2 wraps as well as a drink, which this is our favorite drink here. It is the Malaro Run juice. So we did get the Ronto-less wrap, and we have the breakfast wrap, which is the egg and sausage and cheese. So we're gonna have breakfast here and then continue on.
All right, the breakfast here at Ronto Roasters was really good. I actually love.
Yeah, that had so much flavor.
That Ronto-less wrap had so much flavor. The meat. Substitute product is really good.
Yeah, and even the breakfast wrap, we always love that.
Yeah, really love that. And also the Malaron Ruin juice, whatever it is, that's our favorite. Disappointed they don't have it in Florida, but glad that we can get it here. So let's just continue through Galaxy's Edge.
And look how empty it is through here today. It is so cool. Much better than when we walked through the one in Florida and the last time we walked through here. So we're just gonna take a gander through the stores here. So it looks like this guy got safely delivered here to Batuu from the Disney Cruise Line. And he's still sleeping, so we'll just leave him be. So we walked into the droid depot. It's the first time we've been in here. It's really neat. Look at all the droid parts. And these are the stations that you can make your droid at. And over here on the side, we just got a whole bin of droids ready to be taken apart to be used for something else. It is time to do our first attraction for the day. We're gonna do Smugglers Run.
Well, you know, I had a bad feeling about that last group, but this is the group I've been waiting for, yes! Come in! I have an opportunity for you all.
So we are gonna leave Batuu for a little bit and head into Frontierland because we have a lightning lane for Big Thunder before we head back and do our individual lightning lane for Rise of the Resistance. All right, it is time for us to go do Rise of the Resistance. Oh, look at the pretty flowers on this tree. Right here.
Oh.
It's really neat. All right, let's go inside and help them out. Oh no, we have been captured. We are being taken in for interrogation. And as we exit Rise of Resistance, look who is out. It is R2-D2. Let's go say hi to him.
All right, I think the scan is pretty good.
And look who else is out. It is Mando and Grogu. Let's go say hi to them as well. That was so cool to be able to see R2-D2 and Mandalorian with Grogu. Really neat meet and greet spot. We're working our way towards Docking Bay 7 because it is time to finally have coffee for the day. And we're going to have those Coco Puff coffee. So let's go get that. And actually, we have not been into Docking Bay 7. This is really cool theming here for the restaurant. Like, check out this table here. You have what looks like some seats attached to a box as well as some barrels to sit on. But looks like our order's ready. So let's go pick up the coffee. All right, so here it is. This is the what is known as the Coco Puff Cold Brew, but it's actually called the Cold Brew Black Calf, which is cold brew coffee topped with sweet cream cheese foam, and of course topped with chocolate puffs or cocoa puffs. So highly rated, let's give it a try.
All right, so this cocoa puff cold brew is so good.
So good.
The cream cheese really just like dissolves down into the coffee. The coffee is just black coffee with the cream cheese foam. And then the cocoa puffs are really fresh today. So
yeah,
they're really good. Not sales.
Yeah, so I highly recommend you try the foam first before you mix it all up because the coffee overpowers the foam with the cream cheese.
But it's really good blended together.
It's really good blended together,
so,
yes.
Gonna finish this up, and then actually we just got on the wait list for Oga's Canteen, so we'll go over there and actually try a couple new items over there.
And that quick, we have made it into Oga's Canteen. About a 5-minute wait on our 15-minute wait list. And of course, we're gonna have to go over and say hi to DJ Rex here in a little bit. All right, for the drink, we have the Blurg Fire, which is Minute Maid lemonade with pomegranate juice and habanero lime. So it might be a little spicy. So I guess we'll find out. And for our snacks, we got the Five Blossom Bread, which is warm pretzel knots with Hawaiian black sea salt, served with Calabrian cheese sauce. Basically fancy cheese with pretzel bites, but should be good.
Hey, all you hurts out there! Try the Jamba Juice! The Statue and Daddy Frog Eggs aren't going to eat themselves, although they may eat each other.
And our second and final drink, we have the Mangoon Tea, which is unsweet tea with chocolate milk, vanilla and cinnamon, topped with vanilla whipped cream, and cinnamon sugar dusted cereal. So interesting to have unsweet tea and milk mixed together with basically Cinnamon Toast Crunch on top. But yeah, we'll give this a try.
Finished up at Oga's Canteen, and just as good as we had before.
Yeah.
Really enjoyed it.
Yeah, we got to try two new non-alcoholic drinks.
Yep.
And they were really delicious.
Yeah, super surprised by that Mugon tea with the tea mixed with the chocolate milk and everything. It kind of had a chai tea flavor.
It was like
flavor.
A chai tea. It mixed so well. We thought it sounded so weird, but it worked so well.
And then the pretzel rolls with the cheese. The cheese is spicy, kind of has like a cayenne pepper in or something, but the flavor is so bold and really good. Really like it.
And the pretzel was nice and soft and
warm.
And warm.
Yeah, definitely recommend those if they're on the regular menu. I hope they stay on the menu because I do miss the bao buns we had last time. So hopefully this is a staple. And I don't know if they have those in Florida. I guess we'll have to check at some point. But yeah, definitely a great time at Oga's today. So I think we're done here in Galaxy's Edge on Batuu. So I think we're going to head back onto planet Earth and go check out some spooky spooks over at the Haunted Mansion.
So as I said, we're going to leave another world and go to the spooky world. So let's go ride the Haunted Mansion.
So Vanessa and I both agree that we prefer the Walt Disney World's Haunted Mansion over this Haunted Mansion, except for at Christmas time, because this one's definitely better at Christmas holidays. So yeah, definitely always a must ride here at the Haunted Mansion. So we're going to either wait around for our Splash Mountain Lightning Lane or do something. But yeah, we have one for Splash Mountain because we want to do it before it gets changed here in California as well. They say in a couple months or two it's supposed to close for its refurbishment. So we definitely have a lightning lane to do that today.
So we have some time before we can do Splash Mountain, so we decided we would go visit some pirates. So we're gonna do Pirates of the Caribbean.
Do I hear 10? A hen for a 10.
I'll give you 20 for the rock. of the Pirates. And unlike the Haunted Mansion, the Pirates here is better than Walt Disney World in our opinion, but yeah, always a good time. So I think our lightning lane is about ready here for Splash Mountain. We're gonna go do that, and then we have another lightning lane set up for Indy season, just opened back up from refurbishment, and it's open, so those will probably be the next two things that we're gonna do.
Just like I just said, we're gonna do Splash Mountain, so we're gonna take a drop down Chicopee Hill right here in Critter Country, but we gotta go around the corner to hit our lightning lane entrance. And I hate water rides, but I'm gonna do this just to be able to see it one more time before they close it down.
Oh no, we are in positions 1 and 2, so let's get ready.
Space Mountain with real mountains in the background. Oh no, here comes the first drop, and we are front heavy, so we'll see how this goes. I'm gonna put you away because I don't want to get bet, so goodbye. Not a good start. Not a good start. That's what we know. Uh-oh. The second drop. Let's go. Whoa! Oh no! Oh no! And we're already soaked, but here comes the big one, so I hope the camera's not run from that last one, but here we go.
I gotta dry the shoe!
I am soaked from the last two, and now there's water on the lens. Everything needs to be dried out. But Vanessa wanted to ride it. She said she needed to get one more in, but we are soaked.
Alright, so as you can see, we are not in the park right now. We decided that we would make the walk back to the room to get changed because, well, everything got soaked. Vanessa's got soaked, and her shoes are a mess. So we need to take a quick break, so we will catch up with you a little later. So go take a little bit of an intermission and join back with us here in a little bit. Alright, so we got ourselves all changed and back into dry clothes, and we have made it back to Disneyland, so let us continue. So now that we're back into the park, we did come into Tomorrowland, and for lunch today we got the mushroom Philly sandwich, which has sauteed mushrooms, bell peppers, caramelized onions, crispy fried red onions and chives, served on a sourdough hoagie with Greek yogurt and french fries. And Vanessa got the veggie wrap, which I guess just veggies. It doesn't say what it is. Served with fries or fruit, and the fruit for that is two cuties.
It's black beans with sun-dried tomato and lettuce and tomato.
And this is the veggie plant-based option.
And now that we had that amazing lunch at the Galactic Grill, let's continue our Star Wars themed day and do the original Star Wars ride, Star Tours, here in Tomorrowland. Hi, C-3PO and R2-D2. How are you guys doing today?
I know I've seen this bag before. Maybe it has a twin.
All right, so just finished up on Star Tours, and man, I think that ride has seen its day. Yeah, it is an old and a classic, but compared to the stuff that's over in Galaxy's Edge, it's definitely a little bit older. But we did get all the prequel scenes, so we did the pod racing and all that stuff. So yeah, I'm not sure what we're gonna do next. Maybe we'll head over towards Fantasyland and start doing those. But yeah, let's continue on with our day.
So we will leave the world of tomorrow and enter the world of fantasy, and we're gonna start our time here at It's a Small World, our favorite small world of all of them.
Thank you.
Okay, next up, we are going to take a wild ride with Mr. Toad through the streets of England. On to the next dark ride, Pinocchio's daring journey. Alright, up next is Arrow's original coaster, the Matterhorn bobsled.
So the Matterhorn is fun, like always.
Yeah.
Little rough, but not too bad.
No, not too bad.
Always worth riding for the history.
Yeah.
Alright, so I was able to, while we were in line, get a lightning lane for Space Mountain. Vanessa's not going to ride it, but I am with my friend that's with us.
Yeah.
And yeah, we're just going to go ride Space Mountain before we go to Indiana Jones. Alright, so after a slight delay, because something caused it to go down, we did finally get to go on Space Mountain, and we did a good ride. Had a good ride on it. Was in row 2. So yeah, just gonna continue around, see what we can get into this afternoon. And we have made it back into Fantasyland, and we're gonna ride Alice in Wonderland, Vanessa's favorite dark ride. And it is now time to leave the world of fantasy, and we will enter the land of adventure, and we'll start with doing the Jungle Cruise.
The moment you've been waiting for, it is the eighth wonder of the world, the backside of water! Woo! O2H!
So, seeing as Indiana Jones is currently down, we are going to stop here at the Tropical Hideaway and get a snack and some food. So I got the new seasonal strawberry shortcake Dole Whip, and Vanessa got the chili mango chamoy one, basically like a Mexican treat. And we also got one chicken and one pork bao bun. And that will conclude our really long and busy but fun day here at Disneyland. Goodbye, Carnation Cafe. Goodbye, Market House / Starbucks. Goodbye, the Crystal Arcade. Goodbye, the Main Street Cinema playing Steamboat Willie. Goodbye, Silver Mickey. Maybe we'll check you out in a couple days. Good night, Main Street Railroad. We'll definitely have to ride you when we come back. And finally, good night way over there, California Adventure. We will see you in the morning. And that will conclude our first day, full day here at the Disneyland Resort. I hope this is coming out okay. I can kind of see in the camera it's a little foggy, and that's because Splash Mountain got the camera a little wet, and actually there is some water in the lens here, so I gotta figure out how to get that out of there or something. If not, if I'm gonna continue the vlog, I might have to do it on my phone for the rest of this trip, but I do need to get that out at some point. But yeah, we had a great day. It's long, we're tired, so hope you enjoyed coming along with us today. Until next time, be safe, be kind, and adventure on. Bye! Thank you for watching our video. If you liked it, be sure to give it a thumbs up. If you've not subscribed to our channel yet, be sure to hit that subscribe button below. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them in the comments section below.